Our little devotional today, I'm just calling Strength to Spare. You know, we're just going to look at Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10, starting with just halfway through that verse to verse 12. This is the Message version or translation. God is strong, listen to this, and He wants you strong. So take everything the Master has set out for you, well-made weapons of the best material, and put them to use so you will be able to stand up to everything the devil throws your way. This is no afternoon athletic contest that we'll all walk away from and forget about in a couple hours. This is for keeps, a life or death fight to the finish against the devil and all his angels. You know, many years ago as a young man, I remember going and seeing this group of guys called the Power Team. And they just impressed me as a little boy. My dad took me and I watched these guys and they were bending steel and ripping phone books in half and breaking concrete and doing all this stuff. And I remember one of the guys came in and he had a refrigerator on his back and he was just walking in. And these guys were strong guys. And I remember growing up watching the World's Strongest Man competition. And most of those competitions were just, you know, maybe they had to lift 1,000 pounds off the ground. And a lot of the times I remember, you know, just these great feats of strength. But I remember watching one guy lift and he was doing the world, you know, record and the deadlift. And he just had to stand up one time with the most amount of weight. And I remember him actually blacking out as he was holding this weight and just started shaking. And all of a sudden he just fell back. Because just that one feat of strength, although it was very impressive, it was very limited. And he could only hold it for just a few seconds without literally just his body just giving way under the pressure of that. And I'm just thinking about the different types of strength. It says that God is strong and He wants you strong. There's all different kinds of strength. I know one of the things that really caught my attention growing up as a young man, you know, were bodybuilders. It's these guys that just constantly were working on their bodies. But it's really wild because the way they compete is they get up on the stage and all they're doing is showing off. That's all they're doing. They're not lifting weights. They're not seeing who can lift the most and who can help the elderly lady carry the most groceries into her house or anything like that. It's just all about pride and vainglory and getting up there and just seeing who they think can look the best. That's not what God's talking about. But that's easily what the church could become, right? We could just go, hey, it's all about how I look and all this kind of stuff, and not really functional. I might call it functional strength. But God wants you functionally strong, and not just strong in one area. I remember watching a young man that was just extremely impressive because he was a smaller guy, but he would just go out on the street and they just, you know, filmed it and put it on YouTube of just going out and just arm wrestling anyone. And they would just have $100 bill on the table and anybody could come up and just try to arm wrestle him. And he would just go for hours and hours and hours arm wrestling guys 2 and 3 times his size and he could beat him. But he just primarily worked on one motion. And so it was very surprising how strong he was, even though he was this tiny guy. But I think of God wanting us strong in multiple different areas. You know, Satan is attacking so many different ways in our day to day. And what I would challenge each of us is to think of becoming strong like a cross training. You know, I've trained in martial arts for many, many years. And if you're only good at one thing, especially like in mixed martial arts competitions, if you're only good at one thing, say standing up and being able to strike, then you're quickly going to be taken down to the ground and they're going to take advantage of you, that of your lack of knowledge and skill being able to defend yourself on the ground. But if you just get really, really, really good on the ground and don't get good at standing up as well and defending yourself, then they will just stand up and beat you senseless. It's very important that you are a balanced fighter, even in the physical realm in today's society. But think about this. I saw one time these guys that were competing in a competition that was the CrossFit competition. It was the world championship. And one of these things that these guys had to do, they had to run a mile. Then right as soon as they got back, they would come right up to a bar and they would start doing pull-ups and they had to do 100 pull-ups. Then once they got their 100 pull-ups done, they would move forward and they would do 100 push-ups. Then right after that, they would move forward and they would do around 250 squats. And then instantly right out of those 250 squats, they would take off running and they would have to finish with another mile run. Can you imagine trying to do 250 squats and then trying to run? You could even see in these world-class athletes, their knees starting to buckle and their legs shaking as their legs were just, you know, just so pumped up and so tired from what they had just been through and then trying to run. And I started thinking about just how the Christian church today needs to be strong in so many different areas to be able to defend what we believe through apologetics. That we need to be great at conquering fear, like we've been talking about earlier this week. We need to be great at evangelism, going out and winning souls. We have to be champions in defeating discouragement in our day. It's discouraging times if you look around at even just our nation. But God is bigger than all of that. And we have to be champions in each one of these areas. We've got to be filled with joy when other people are discouraged. And we've got to be able to transfer that over to them. What I didn't share with you is about this CrossFit competition, this world-class competition, is that they were all wearing something. They were wearing a vest that was weighted. They had weights on this entire time. They weren't just carrying their own body weight. If they were just doing that, that would have been amazing and incredible that they could propel their body forward for a mile and then 100 push-ups, 100 pull-ups, 250 squats, and then run another mile. That was incredible in just a matter of a few minutes. But they did it all while carrying extra weight, every one of them. And I started thinking, you know, are you strong enough physically? Have you been training in the Word of God? Have you been training on your knees in prayer? That not only can you get through your day victoriously, but that you can help all those around you. Are you strong enough to carry those who are weak? Do you have enough faith to dig through the roof when somebody else doesn't have that faith and lower them down before Christ? I want the strength to be able to carry the lame into His presence. I want to walk so close to Him that the spiritually blind can see Him in me. I want to speak so kindly and clearly that the spiritually deaf that maybe can't hear God themselves, they can hear His voice in me. You know, just this last week, we were just training the kids in TMMA, and one of the things that we were making them do is do all these different exercises down the floor. And at different points, what we will do is we will make them not just do the exercises, but do the exercises while they're carrying their partner up and down the floor. And I just thought about that, how spiritually, every single one of us, God is saying, listen, I had enough strength to come down and save all of you. I'm strong, and I want you to be strong, not just personally for you, but for those who are weak around you, those you're supposed to be encouraging and strengthening every single day. Let me ask you a question. Whose eternal soul may be depending on your character, your strength, your testimony, maybe your courage, your faith, to help them get there, to actually get to a place of trusting God without reservation. Listen to what the scripture says. It says, and we urge you, brothers, admonish. Another version says, warn the idle. Encourage the faint-hearted. How would you do that unless you were stronger? Unless you could see further, unless you had more faith and you say, they're starting to lose faith, let me pour courage. I'm going to share some of my faith with them. Then he says, help the weak. So you know, remember, you know, when like the military, they're training at different times, their personal scores, their time for their personal run may not be what they're keeping track of. It may be the time that once all of their whole platoon or whatever their group they're in gets across. And so it may take some of the stronger ones to work even harder to come alongside the weak ones and say, here, let me carry your weapon. Let me carry your backpack. Let me help you across. Let me help you get there. So he says, help the weak and be patient with them all. That's 1 Thessalonians 5:14, the ESV. So we win when we all get across the line. Think about it. Who in your family do you want to leave behind? I know for me, I don't want any of them left. I don't want to just get there. I want to get there with my wife and my children and my brother and my sisters and my nephews and my cousins and my uncles and my aunts and my neighbors. I want them all to get there. And I want to be strong enough that when they're getting weak, that I can pull. And I understand that if we all train like this, when we get weak, there'll be others that are strong to come alongside us and help us. That's God's design. That's His plan. Let's start training so that we can train hard enough and be strong enough that we can help others. And when we get weak, they can help us. May it be so in this church right here. God bless you.